I'm Richard Harrison, your student body president.
And I'm Ramon Womba, your student body vice president. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please pause for a moment of silence.
Good morning, Spring Valley and TGIF. Morgan Osborne here for your WSV News. Today is our annual Mr. Spring Valley pageant. Come out and watch these boys show off their moves, talents, and good looks. The tickets are $5 in advance from any sophomore student council member or Ms. Schwartzbauer. The tickets are $7 at the door. Now here's a look at your Mr. Spring Valley contestants.
I want to be Mr. Spring Valley because I'm Marcus Hughes, and you know, it's on my 18th birthday, and what better way to celebrate than winning, you know? And you know, while they put my sash on, everybody's gonna break out in song, sing happy birthday.
Like, my favorite thing about Mr. Spring Valley would definitely have to be the entertainment. I love entertaining people. Like, I think I'm pretty awesome.
JT.
I can't wait till I get you on the floor, good looking. Hey, going hot, so hot, just like an oven.
The festivities begin at 7 p.m. in the Spring Valley Auditorium. We have some really great boys running, and you won't want to miss these performances. Now to Lakia with the sports.
Happy Friday, Vax. Lakia here with your sports update. Even though ASAP testing went on all week, we still had lots of teams in action. Both JV and varsity softball teams were victorious in the region matchup against Irmo Tuesday night. JV won with a score of 10-3, while varsity took them 9-2. The girls' varsity soccer team lost to Irmo 2-1, and the boys' soccer team also took a hard loss 1-0. Wednesday night, both track teams defeated Blythewood, C.A. Johnson, Arnie, and Ridgeview, and they improved their records to 12-0. This is the boys' 7th undefeated season in a row and their 7th region championship in a row. The boys' tennis team defeated Aiken Wednesday night 4-2, and the boys' lacrosse team took a hard loss to Chapin 14-9 on Monday, but redeemed themselves by defeating Arnie 17-5. Last night and became the region champs. All of our teams in action today will face Lugoff Elgin, varsity baseball, JV softball, and both boys soccer teams will all travel to LE, while the girls soccer teams will face them here at home. That's your update. Back to you, Morgan.
Thanks, Lakia. Attention all students, if you are interested in joining the International Club next year, come to Mr. Grantham's room E321 during lunch this upcoming Monday, April 7th, for an interest meeting. Seniors, do you have a name that is spelled or pronounced in a unique way? If so, make sure you stop by Mr. Grantham's class to make sure he pronounced it correctly at graduation. Also, if you have not turned in your permission form or paid for the senior trip to Carowinds, please remember to do so quickly. You only have until April 11th, and if you didn't know, Spring Valley will not be one of the only schools there from the district. Other schools from the district will also be attending. And we have a tie for senior movie night between White Chicks and The Great Gatsby. So go online today and vote for your favorite. We had an overwhelming response for the student-faculty basketball game, scheduled for next Friday. After looking at discipline and grades, the list of participants will be posted on the door of student activities after third period today. Start making plans now for the game. The cost is 50 cents per individual or $15 per class. Armbands will be given out next Friday by 7th period teachers, and they will be sold at the door if any parents want to come and enjoy the game. All the proceeds this year will be donated to Special Olympics. That's all your news for today. Have a great weekend, Vikings!